What's going on, moviegoers? If you're new to the channel, my name is Krishna. Welcome to SeaWorld Productions. You guys, Morbius has been delayed yet again. For the seventh time, you guys. Morbius has been delayed seven times. Seven times. Let's go over the dates, shall we? So, it went from July 10th, 2020. Then it went to July 31st, 2020. Then it went to March 19th, 2021. October 8th, 2021, January 1st, 2022, January 28th, you guys, 2022, and now, April 1st, 2022. I'm kind of bummed. I was looking forward to Morbius. I think Morbius looks fantastic. I think Jared Leto's gonna kill it as Michael Morbius. I'm excited about it. And then when January finally hit, I was like, yes, we get to see Morbius this month. I'm excited. We have nothing until the Batman. Marvel World, nothing now until Doctor Strange in the Multiverse of Madness. No, you still have April. April, then May. So we still get Morbius before Doctor Strange 2. But I was looking forward to something this month, you guys. I really was. I was hyped. I was excited. Now, you guys, let's talk. Let's talk. Why is Morbius delayed after Sony just had one of the most highest grossing movies of all time, that being Spider-Man No Way Home. Killing it domestically, killing it worldwide. Up there with The Force Awakens and Avengers Endgame. Why would Sony delay that? Morbius has a direct tie-in to Spider-Man No Way Home. It's a Marvel movie. It's Sony. Doesn't make any sense. I know that there's this new variant out and people are scared to go out again. But that shit's been here all month. For December. And No Way Home still crushed the numbers. Now, I'm not saying that Morbius and No Way Home should be put in the same sentence. I'm not saying that. Trust me. Come on now. I'm not saying that at all. Sinister Six, three Spider-Man versus one, you know, living vampire. Come on now. But I would think you would think Sony's like, yo, let's ride this high right now. We are riding on the high. We're killing it right now. We are killing it at the box office. Everybody's loving it. They're making a push at the Oscars for Best Motion Picture this year. Kind of doesn't make sense. Because if I'm Sony, I'm like, you know what? You know, No Way Home is still making money. It's going to make money all of January as well. I might end up making about $1.7 billion in total of its whole theatrical run. Big stuff. And then by the time Morbius comes, the hype is still there. Oh, well, Morbius. And you can even do some marketing to kind of tie in, you know, No Way Home to Morbius or whatever. What if Sony has heard the cries? Make The Amazing Spider-Man 3. Sony wants Andrew Garfield back. They're delaying this movie by multiple months. Could they be doing reshoots to add in Andrew Garfield Spider-Man? Could be a possibility. Could be a great possibility. You can't deny anything right now, especially with the multiverse. Anything is possible. We got William Dafoe back. William DeGoat back in No Way Home. Damn near 20 years ago, he did Spider-Man. Anything is possible. That's exciting. If that's true and that's the case, shit, delay it another 6 months. Take your time with it, homie. But I doubt they would kind of throw an Andrew Garfield Spider-Man into the story, especially when this movie's kind of been done for fucking damn near 2 years now. It's been done. But this is exciting, man. Like, the idea of having Andrew Garfield back in the Spider-Man universe is really exciting. There's so many great opportunities that they can go and do. A lot. Spider-Gwen, you know, or him versus Tom Hardy Spider-Man. I mean, Tom Hardy's Venom. Endless possibilities, you guys. They could really, really have some fun with this multiverse stuff. But that brings it to the question, well, what about Michael Keaton? Why is Michael Keaton in Morbius? He's in the MCU. And the way No Way Home ended, why would he be kind of recruiting Michael Morbius? He no longer should be after Spider-Man. Well, he could be after Spider-Man. He just doesn't know his identity anymore. Now that nobody knows Spider-Man's true identity. So everybody in No Way Home, Far From Home, nobody in that specific timeline or in any timeline knows who Spider-Man is now. Or would that just be Tom Holland Spider-Man? And the different universes, they still know Peter Parker, Spider-Man. Is it just in the MCU, they don't know who Spider-Man's identity? Big question mark there, you guys. Yo, look, I'm excited for the future. Am I bummed that Morbius is delayed for the seventh time? Absolutely. Absolutely, because I was looking forward to it. I even told my wife. I was like, look, make sure you got that day off. I need to go see Morbius. Sure, whatever. Now that's not happening. Now I'm not saying no Morbius this month, you guys. I was looking forward to it. But that doesn't stop Marvel from dropping Moon Knight in February, which has kind of been some ramblings I've been hearing. Could be a possibility. That would be awesome. I know there are a lot of Moon Knight comics being pushed out in February and in March and in April. Usually, when Marvel is about to introduce a new character in the MCU, they start making all these reprints. And that's what's happening. So Morbius could drop, not Morbius, Moon Knight could drop legit in the next 2 to 3 months. And that could be completely fine with me because we gonna need something. Yeah, right now, the only thing we kind of have is what, Boba Fett and, you know, the Peacemaker, which I'm like, eh. Are you guys even interested in the Peacemaker? And just, look, I love the Suicide Squad. I think that show looks corny as fuck. That's just me. But post your comments down below. Let me know what you guys think about Morbius being delayed for the seventh time. Could this be for reshoots to add in a particular Spider-Man or Andrew Garfield Spider-Man? Thoughts and opinions, I want to know. Post them down below. Peace.